If you are troubling in passing your urine, if you are facing a foggy, a cloudy or a very smelly urine, or if you are facing a pain in your backside, a pinching pain or more than it, or if you are facing blood in your urine, or if you are facing a severe urge for urinate, and when you go for urine, there is a small urine come with a severe pain. So if you are facing any of these symptoms, then it may be possible that you are a patient of kidney stone. A kidney stone is inside you. So for diagnosing it, you can go for simple tests such as x-ray, CT scan or urine test after consulting a doctor. But if you had done all these tests and you know there is a kidney stone inside you, then now this video is just for you, because in this video I'm gonna tell you some best treatment from which you can get rid of your kidney stone permanently. Hey everyone, this is Aagam Singh Sisodiya and you're watching Disease Media. So before proceeding further to know about the treatment of this kidney stone, let's first introduce with the cause, the root cause of this kidney stone, because without knowing the root cause of this kidney stone, we are not able to treat our kidney stone permanently. There are two important causes of these kidney stones. The first, the concentrated urine, means that the amount of waste product in the urine is more while the water content is less. It's like a situation when waste water travels with lots of water from a drainage or from a sewage pipe, but when the amount of water content becomes less and the amount of waste product becomes more, then the waste product start to accumulate inside the pipe or inside the sewage line or in the sewage pipe and start to chalk that pipe. As such occurs with our body, when there is a concentrated urine, the waste products are more, so they start to accumulate there and start the formation of kidney stone. And second reason is that if your urine contains lots of amount of calcium or uric acid like substances and some crystal forming substances also, then the crystal forming substances start to collaborate with the calcium or the uric acid and form the crystal there. For example, in most of the cases, the kidney stone is formed of calcium oxalate. Calcium is a different compound and oxalate is a crystal forming compound that binds with the calcium and form the kidney stone. So now you know that these are the two important causes of the kidney stone. Now let's move on to know about the treatment of the kidney stone, that how we can get rid of it. The first treatment is a household natural remedy that you can do at your home very easily, that you have to take 2 or 3 leaves of Calculi pinnata, also known as Pathar Chatta in Hindi. That's a type of bryophyte plant that you can get anywhere in your garden or in your neighbor house or in a plant nursery. You can purchase that plant from a plant nursery. It can even grow with a single leaf. So the treatment is, you have to take 2 or 3 leaves of that Calculi pinnata or the Pathar Chatta, just chow it properly and then drink a large amount of water after that in an empty stomach. Just do it twice in a day, at in the morning, at in the evening. If chewing is not possible for you, then you can make the juice of Calculi pinnata leaves and then drink it easily, and then after that drink a large amount of water after that. Just take this treatment for 2 to 3 weeks. You are definitely going to get out the kidney stone from your body. As Calculi pinnata contains a special chemical which binds with the calcium oxalate crystal and start to dissolve it, start to break it so that it can pass easily from your urine. And it also stops the formation of further crystals and kidney stone, as it binds with the oxalate, that is a crystal forming substance for calcium. The second treatment is an Ayurvedic medicine which you can purchase from an Ayurvedic store very easily. The product name is Eurocure Herbal Alkalizer. It is a specific formula for kidney stone and urinary bladder stone. It contains lots of Ayurvedic medicines such as Kalmi Sora, Gokhru, Giloy and lots of many, which are specific for the removal of kidney stone from your body. One more thing I want to clear here, that this product is not a sponsored product. This is not an advertising deal. It's the genuine experience of the people which used it. They actually get the benefit from it. That's why I'm telling you. Okay, now let's talk about the doses of this medicine, that how you have to take it. You just have to take a complete glass filled with water. The glass should to be non-metallic. And after that, you just have to add 2 tablespoonful of this medicine, or just take the 2 caps of that, and you just have to add that in that water and that drink it after meal twice a day. Just take this medicine 2 to 3 weeks or just a month, you are definitely going to get rid of your kidney stone permanently. And if you are not able to get any of these medicines such as the Pathar Chatta or the Calculi leaves, or you are not able to get this Ayurvedic syrup also, then you should have to consult a nearby doctor or a nearby urologist. They will prescribe some medicines regarding it, in which the beta blocker medicines are also included. The beta blockers are the special types of medicine which relaxes the urinary tract so that the stone which is stuck in there get the way to get downward with the flow of water and get out from your body. And one thing that you have to know, that you have to drink lots and lots of water so that the kidney stone can get flushed out from your body. So now you know that, what are the treatments to get rid of your kidney stone? But now what I'm going to say is again very important, because these are the precaution measures that will save you from the further upcoming kidney stones in your future. So for saving yourself from the upcoming kidney stone, you just have to follow these 5 lifestyle changes. The first lifestyle change is that you have to reduce the amount of salt and sugar in your diet, as the excessive amount of salt in your body increases the concentration of calcium in your urine. And due to excessive amount of calcium in your urine, the chances of kidney stone formation becomes more. The second lifestyle change is that you have to drink at least 1 glass of lemon juice in the whole day, as it contains citrates which bind with the oxalate and stop the formation of kidney stone. The third lifestyle change is that you have to reduce the amount of oxalate containing food. The oxalates, as you know, that they are the crystal forming substance. So you just have to reduce the amount of oxalate containing foods if you are more prone to kidney stone. The oxalate containing foods are spinach, almonds, or certain type of beans, or tea, or some other products which are on your screens. Just read them and reduce the amount of them in your diet so that you can get rid of your kidney stones. Next lifestyle change is difficult for non-vegetarian people, as they have to reduce the amount of animal protein such as eggs, meat, or the chicken in your diet, because when you eat a large amount of animal protein, it increases the amount of uric acid in your body, and that also increases the chance of kidney stone formation. And the final lifestyle change is that you have to drink a lot and lot of amount of water in the whole day. You already know about this point, but the problem is that you forgot to drink the water. So for this forgetting problem, you just have to set 1 hour of timer in the whole day. You just have to drink water after 1 hour, and again then you have to switch 1 hour of timer so that you can't forget when you have to drink a glass of water. And also with that, I just want to clear some misconception regarding kidney stone that people think about that. Some people think that drinking a beer is good for kidney stone, as it breaks the kidney stone, it flushes out the kidney stone. But this is a misconception. It is not right. Beer is an alcohol which does not break the kidney stone. It doesn't flushes it out. It is a misconception. Even that it is an alcohol, it can damage your kidneys. And there are certain type of exercises for the treatment of kidney stone that you can do, that you have to go for jogging, certain type of cardio exercise, jumping, or certain type of breathing exercise such as Kapalbhati, that creates pressure inside your body and that will help to get out the kidney stone from your body. Next misconception is regarding milk and milk product, that certain people think that milk and milk product increases the chances of kidney stone as it contains calcium. But this is not right, because calcium is not the only one which increases the formation of kidney stone, as when calcium binds with the oxalate, it forms the kidney stone. But oxalate is required, and if the amount of calcium is more in your urine, that is responsible due to your salt intake. The more salt you take, the more calcium is there in your urine. So you just have to limit the amount of oxalate food or the amount of salt, and don't blame calcium for the formation of kidney stone. And one more misconception regarding kidney stone is that some people think that the kidney stone pains like a stomach pain, but this is not right. The kidney stone pain is more than a delivery of a baby. Means that when a mother gives birth to a baby, there is a severe pain there, but the kidney stone pain is more severe than that pain. And finally, a most important point is there, that if you are having a very large size of kidney stone that is not dissolving or broken down with any type of medicine or any type of home remedy, then you should go for a surgical treatment. For that, you should have to consult a specialist, a urologist. They will suggest you that which type of surgical treatment is best for you and which one is painless. So these are the misconceptions which you have to clear about kidney stone, and also have to follow the treatment steps so that you can get rid of your kidney stone. And also don't forget to do the lifestyle changes, as they are going to prevent you from the further upcoming kidney stones. And if this video helps you in understanding any of your concepts, please give it a thumbs up. Please share this video with your family and friends, because by sharing this video, you are creating awareness about kidney stone and its treatment. And if you haven't subscribed this channel, please subscribe this channel. Press the bell icon and select all to get more notifications about these type of videos. So that's all for today. I will see you later in the next video.